All right, so today we're gonna be working on the 21 WRX. We already put in our MAPerformance intake and it sounds sick. Now we're gonna do our axle-back muffler delete. Put these bad boys on, get rid of those ginormous mufflers, save on some weight, and get some better sound. All right guys, so when you get down here, you're gonna have to take the mufflers off. It's really, really easy, self-explanatory. There's gonna be two bolts here, 14 millimeter, right there, right? And then each one of these mufflers is sitting on two hangers, right? So this one right here. And then the other is on the, I don't know if you can see, right there. And then the same thing for the other side. You got the inboard, and then there's one on the outboard. I'm not sure if you can see it, right there. So once you get those two bolts and two bolts off, and then it'll be kind of just be suspended by the hangers. You just rip them off the hangers and then throw your new ones on. Alright, so this first side's loosened. You can see I got the bolts out. And now it's just kind of hanging here on the hangers. Right there. Just recommend using some WD-40. To lube the where the the metal and the rubber meet, and it'll help just slide right over. It's like a dream, what she feels with me. She loves. Let's see if I can do this with one hand. So this is how the hanger's set up, is that there's a metal that's attached to the car that basically holds this rubber piece. And this part, this long piece, is from the exhaust. So you wanna take the exhaust out of the rubber and leave the rubber there. Or you can take the rubber off, it really doesn't matter, but it's the easiest way is if you just leave that on, kind of just loop that up there, so that basically this will slide right out. Out with the old, in with the new. So all that we're doing now is basically just, so we got on the hangers, right? You can see there, still working on it. But now you just gotta kinda like, kinda figure out what's the good position where it sits nicely and the intended well. And then you gotta, of course, get them to line up. So that's what we're doing now. So an important thing I didn't mention is that when you buy most aftermarket exhaust, they're gonna come with a gasket. It's basically like a little spacer. Basically it goes in between where the two points connect, where the two exhausts meet, and it prevents any like exhaust leaks and stuff like that, and it helps fix the gapping, the spacing that's there. So because we bought used, he didn't give us the gaskets. So we're gonna, just gonna mount it up now, seal it as best we can. And we might have a small exhaust leak, but it shouldn't be anything crazy. But we'll go back with gaskets and make sure we do it right.